Currently, with a generation of 1.6 megawatts, 5,700 islanders are connected to power. On top of this, the government has offered 3,000 free meters for those who have been lagging behind.
Whereby government gave 2,000 meters, whereby people are not going to pay money, just on the inspection fee. That is a smaller amount as compared to the one we are charging now.
Islanders who wanted new connections have been paying between 800,000 Uganda shillings to 1.4 million. But through this program, they will only pay an inspection fee of 48,000 shillings. Also, the government is installing a power submarine cable that will connect the island to the main national grid after discovering that this hybrid station has not been doing well, accompanied with constant load shedding.
Sometime in June this year, we realized that, of course, power business was not doing well, and we started the load shedding. But even before coming to load shedding, we had requested the government, to initiate a project whereby we can increase on the power production in Mbugala. And, of course, that's why Marine Cable came on board.
Addressing the media on power supply, Joseph Mulindwa, the Kalangala Infrastructure Services Limited spokesperson, narrated that more benefits are coming with this submarine cable power tariff reduction inclusive.
Government is going to set the new tariff through Electricity Regulatory Authority. And of course, the marine cable is coming with so many benefits.
According to Lukwago Lad, the power plant manager, the two systems will be well managed, where one will be operational at once.
We're going to prioritize. In case it's daytime and we are having enough of the solar, it means we shall be blocking power from the other side, and then we use power from the solar system. When it comes to evening and we are not having enough solar to supply, it means we shall open from this side of ours, and then priority will be given to the other side of the marine cable.
Disan Bisula, one of the customers, says the marine cable program might see other islands benefiting, since Kalangala Infrastructure Services Limited will be able to open up other stations.
We hope that the marine cable will first of all connect us 24 hours, and we hope that the marine cable will be linked to also other islands, because it has been serving only one island, Bugala, and the nearest islands have not been having power. So we hope this project will be expanded.
In Kalangala, when we did not have power at all, but right now we have a lot of developments that we can associate with the keys and the power that we have. Now that we are getting a marine cable, we know that power will not be on and off as it has been for some time.
Currently, over 60 people have completed their application documents for the free power connection, topping up on 400 who were left behind in 2021 after government closure of the Electricity Connection Policy Program. Report by Samuel Nkuba for the news.